gentlemen, once again, these two heavyweights weigh 205 pounds. Both of them are fighting here in their first ever MMA match. First up in the blue corner, he's 22 years old. He fights for Esteem BJJ out of Petaluma, California, by way of Point Reyes, Johnny King Avalos. His opponent in the red corner, 35 years old, fights for Hayes Martial Arts out of Fremont, California. He is Josh Red Hulk Schilling. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please disable your flash.
Oh man, so we'll see. Might see some, maybe some crazy kicks. All right, here we go. Joshua Schilling in the red corner and Juan Avalos over in the blue corner. These guys are both at 205. This is a light heavyweight bout. Again, amateur, so 3 2-minute rounds.
Pulling each other out now. Oh, he goes for the throw and just missed it.
Oh, and here we go. Schilling is in half guard. But Avalos quickly getting up. So it looks like Schilling wants to be standing up.
Yeah, Schilling lets Avalos back to his feet. Both men back standing. Let's see what happens. Nice overhand.
Avalos is coming in very, very wide, winging punches. Very, doesn't look like he's got very good balance on his feet when he's coming in like that. So he needs to slow it down just a little bit, be a little bit more calculated, and take way better shots than what he just took.
I agree, Robbie. He's not really taking his time with those shots. He's just not setting them up, just shooting out of nowhere, and Schilling able to defend it.
So what Avalos needs to do is use that jab to set up his takedown. That's exactly what he's doing. Instead of just changing level, this isn't a wrestling match. You have to be worried about the kicks, you have to be worried about the uppercut, the overhand, everything.
Absolutely. You can't be one-dimensional in the sport of mixed martial arts. You have to be all well-rounded as far as the wrestling goes.
Oh, nice knee by Schilling.
As far as wrestling and the jiu-jitsu, as well as the striking. Nice overhand right landing by Avalos. Interesting. He pulls him down into guard. I guess those takedown attempts failed, so he just decides to pull him to guard instead.
Man, Schilling had great success with that knee. If I was Schilling, I'd stand it right back up, let him charge enemy, backpedal, and throw knees.
He probably figured he's got this round one, so he's just going to secure the top position, and that's the end of the round number one. So far, I got this fight score 10-9 in favor of Schilling right now. He did the more damage. Was able to stake off those takedowns and landed the more significant strikes.
I don't know what to call that one exactly. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to go over with the red corner on this one, Schilling.
If
anybody is and lives in San Francisco, Dragon House is the place to go to train if you want to be a fighter. If you don't want to be a fighter and just learn how to defend yourself, the perfect place to go.
Absolutely, fight fans. Shout out to you guys live streaming this show here at Dragon House 24. The best live mixed martial arts event in Northern California, has been for the last 6 years. Been hosting the largest, most exciting fights in Northern California, showcasing the best amateur and pro talent.
Shots landed by Schilling. Again, Avalos needs to set those shots up. He needs to stop changing levels. And the key thing that when I coach my wrestlers in the high school level, don't just drop levels and not step in. You have to shoot past your opponent. All I see Avalos doing is just changing levels without stepping in. You need to shoot past your opponent. That's the goal, is to go through them.
Absolutely, Robbie. Well said. Basically, needs to stop telegraphing those shots.
Exactly.
Nice over here. Righty rushes forward with a flurry of punches. And now he's got Schilling pushed up against the fence. Looks to be going for that double.
There we go. There we go.
Oh, close. Go again.
Black. There we go.
Looks like sweep, he's got it.
There
he's got
you
it.
Go.
He's got it.
All right. Avalos with a takedown.
Now this is interesting. Avalos coming from a Brazilian jiu-jitsu school. I want to see what he does on the ground here. Right now in half guard, staying dominant on top, landing some vicious strikes here. Schilling's in a lot of trouble right now.
Now, what I want to see Avalos do right now is he can actually take it. There you go. That's exactly what I wanted to see him do.
He's got full mounts. Schilling gives up his back. Schilling in all kinds of trouble right now.
Nice big shots from Avalos over here. I want to see him get those hooks in. Get those hooks in.
Looks like
flatten him out.
Looks like he's going for that rear naked. Yeah, he does need to get that left hook stunk in there.
Schilling could pop out the back right now. He just needs to posture up and pull back.
He might not have enough time. Both men back to their feet.
All right. That was a good round. Good round for Avalos.
Avalos definitely made a statement there. If the fight was 1-0 in favor of Schilling, I guarantee you now it is a tie score. It should be 1-1. I favored Avalos in that round, 10-9 definitely. Able to get that takedown and secure his top position and land a lot of significant strikes there.
Here we go. Third and final round. Schilling looks a little tired.
Yeah, he definitely has his mouth open a little wider, breathing a little heavily. Avalos still looks like he has energy, bouncing around the cage. Schilling needs to try to keep this fight standing. He did a very good job in
nice
that first round.
Nice job,
staking off those takedowns. But he needs to do the same if he wants to win this fight in this third round here.
You know, I was really hoping Schilling would open up with a lot more kicks because he's got nice range with his legs, it seems like. A lot more leg kicks.
Absolutely. He's definitely got the height advantage. Probably got the reach advantage as well. But like you said, he might be a little gassed now. Looks like both fighters taking their time. Then he explodes with a 1-2. Avalos again. Oh, that uppercut landed. Avalos seems unfazed by it. Throws an overhand right of his own. Nice inside leg kick.
Nice kick by Avalos.
Yes. Once again, going for that takedown.
He's got one. He needs to go with that single leg.
Nice counter by Schilling, able to land on top. Able to posture up. He needs to be looking to throw some strikes here.
None of those landed, from what I can see.
Yeah, he lets Avalos back to his feet. Smart move, I think, though. He's definitely got the advantage in stand-up, so he figures to keep the fight standing. I'm guessing Avalos is still going to try to get that last takedown, try to secure this fight.
10 seconds left on the clock.
Nice overhand. Ooh, nice uppercut. These guys are going to brawl out to the end of the round.
Nice, nice end of the round.
What a fight.
Good job to both these amateurs. Good job.
Great performance by Juan Avalos and Joshua Schilling tonight. Trying to make a statement for Fight Night of the Night. This is going to be a close fight to score for the judges. I have Schilling winning the first round 10-9. Avalos winning the second round 10-9. So the third round is going to be decided back there.
Ladies and gentlemen, our judges have rendered a unanimous decision. All three judges scored the fight 29-28 in favor of the winner. In the red corner, Josh Redhawk Schilling!
Josh Schilling gets the win here tonight. Excellent performance, dominated that fight. It's the judge's decision by unanimous.